May I request you all, please hold your hands and close your eyes. Prayer pause. Om Rim Namo Arahantanam. Om Rim Namo Siddhanam.
A warm welcome to everyone to the 16th annual Jaina workshop at SOAS, opening the 16th annual Jaina lecture at SOAS, opening the 18th Jaina studies workshop this year on Jainism and science. The theme of this year's conference has raised eyebrows amongst some academics who either believe the humanities and the natural sciences to be entirely disconnected fields of study, or that the higher popular modernist discourse on the scientific credentials of the teachings of Jainism, using the word science, or rather its Sanskrit equivalents, vidya, vijnanam, jnanam, shastram, etc., in a rather loose fashion, as in Scientology. However, there's no doubt that the Jaina texts offer ample material for the historian of science. I think we can consider ourselves lucky to be able to welcome amongst us a considerable number of the few scholars who have mastered both the philological and philosophical, mathematical and natural scientific skills that are necessary to ascertain the specialized contribution of Jaina texts to the history of science, not to speak of the ethics of science. On behalf of us all, I would like to thank all speakers and visiting scholars attending this conference for their willingness to share their knowledge and ideas with us. We are extremely delighted that Professor Anupam Jain of the Government Degree College in Sanwar, Indore, one of the leading experts in the world on the mathematics in Jaina texts, has accepted our invitation to deliver the 16th annual Jaina lecture tonight. He will be introduced a little later by Dr. Ratna Kumar Shah from Pune. But first, I would like to thank the sponsors of the conference. Without their generosity, an annual event like the Jaina Studies Workshop could not be sustained. The main sponsor of this conference is the Gyan Sagar Foundation from Delhi, which currently sponsors the newsletter of the Center of Jaina Studies as well. You see it here. If you haven't got one yet, I have more copies outside. I'm also very excited about this title picture in particular, which is from the Ashmolean Museum in Oxford, by the way, which is, has an excellent collection of Jaina objects. This newsletter for the first time features an ISSN number as well and is collected now by specialized libraries around the world. Dr. Sugani, General Secretary of the Jan Sagar Foundation, will later give a brief information talk on Jan Sagar Maharaj and the foundation. Main sponsors are also Anil and Lata Chandaria, long-term well-wishers of the COJS from London, and the Jeev Dyer Foundation in Dallas, both of which have regularly supported our workshops and Prakrit course offerings, for which we also received donations by well-wishers who preferred to remain anonymous. I would like to also point out to the wonderful crowdfunding webpage produced by SOAS doctoral student Adrian Plough, noting that crowdfunding doesn't work so well in the Jain community, who's individually contributing tremendously, but doesn't consider itself to be a crowd, you know. But we managed, or he managed in this way, to raise the amount required, which is admirable. Last but not least, the research fund of the Faculty of Arts and Humanities here at SOAS has to be mentioned. We are most grateful to our speakers who have made a special effort to come to inform us all about their latest research findings and to their universities, some of which supported their journey to SOAS. On behalf of us all, I would like to thank all the sponsors and speakers whose contributions are enabling us to keep the conference open to the public without charge and to learn more about the rich heritage of the Jaina tradition. Let us give them a big hand. One notable change in the program has to be announced at this point. To my great pleasure, Professor Hampana Nagarajaya from Bangalore has belatedly agreed to grace our workshop with his presence and to offer a paper on Pachacana leading to Salehana, a topical issue with significant implications for medical ethics. To create space for this interesting contribution, the announced paper of the present speaker had to give way. Finally, I would like to thank the opportunity to invite everyone already now to the reception following the annual Jain lecture in the Brunei suite upstairs. It's all vegan, vegetarian, of course. Please note, and this is in response to last year's events, that as per convention for keynote annual lectures, there will be no public discussion following Professor Anupam Jain's lecture, and you can have a private conversation then in the suite, which is a different arrangement from the workshop tomorrow. Before I hand over to Professor Wright, our president at the Center of Jain Studies, who will honor this year's winner of the undergraduate Jaina Essay Prize, I have to dispense myself from a pleasant duty. That is the launch of 4 books published in 2 different monograph series edited by the COJS. The Jaina Studies series with Harasowiz, let me start first with the other one. The Leverhulme Trust funded edition, let us start then with this, okay. The Jaina Studies series with Harasowiz was set up for books that exceeded the word limit of the Routledge series, which we all know about. The Leverhulme Trusted funded edition of the long-forgotten encyclopedic bibliographical work of Johannes Klatt, the Jaina Onomasticon here, left by the author in form of a nearly completed manuscript before falling ill in 1892. is a major contribution to China studies. Sadly, co-editor Cornelius Krümpelmann, who did most of the editing work, cannot be with us tonight, but sends his best wishes to everyone. We commend Klutz's work to your librarian. It's 1,000 pages, you can't see it here, and it will appear in June, according to the publishers. And last but not least, three volumes in the Routledge series appeared last year, and I also recommend them. There are many other books one could announce, but here is another one from Hasmita Shah, Lest We Forget, A Journey of Migration Across the Seas in Search of a Better Future. I suppose this is about the Oswald community in the UK. Yeah. And well, let us congratulate her to this achievement as well. And with this, move forward to the honoring ceremony. Thank you very much.
Can I ask Helen Poulter to come to the rostrum, please? I have pleasure in formally handing Helen Poulter her certificate for winning the SOAS Undergraduate Essay Prize in Jain Studies on the theme of Mahavira and Vegetarianism. Helen Poulter.
Professor Dr. Ratna Kumar Shah now to introduce our keynote speaker.
Good evening, everybody. I am Ratna Kumar Shah. Not Dr. Ratna Kumar Shah from Pune. It gives me great pleasure in introducing Dr. Anupam Jain, Professor Anupam Jain from Indore, to this august assembly of research scholars. Actually, I was very unfortunate in the sense I got introduced to Dr. Anupam Jain only at my age of 72, when he was aged 51 only. But since then, for the last 7 years, we are in constant touch, as well as we are working on various projects, and he's a sort of inspiration, guide, friend, and philosopher to me. It was due to his encouragement only that made my smooth transition from insurance area to research in genealogy, in particular mathematics, in ancient Jaina scriptures. His parents, I think, exhibited great intuition in naming him Anupam, meaning unparalleled. He started his career as a researcher and teacher in mathematics at the age of 22 in 1980, after completing MSc, MPhil in mathematics. He did his PhD in history of mathematics in 1992, and his thesis on contribution of Jaina Sen scholars in mathematics was highly acclaimed. This determined the mission of his life, and for the last 35 years, He is engaged in continuous propagation of research in this area, besides his regular duties of teaching mathematics and guiding PhD students, and despite of his 9 transfers to various colleges in Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh, being in government service. However, the alma mater of his activities had been mainly Indore from Madhya Pradesh. Right from his PhD days, he made it as a mission of his life to bring to light the hidden jewels of mathematical ideas in Jaina cosmology, metaphysics, and karma theory. Out of 12 PhDs supervised by him, 10 were in the area of Jaina mathematics, 1 in Vedic mathematics, and 1 in applied mathematics, his actually original discipline. Out of 90 research articles by him, published in various international and national journals, commemorative volumes, etc., as many as 82 are on Jaina mathematics. Out of 8 articles communicated and awaiting publication, 5 are in this area and 3 in the area of applied mathematics. He actively supervised 15 projects undertaken by MSc students, out of which 8 were in the area of Jaina mathematics and 7 in general mathematics. At present, he is guiding 2 PhD students. One is working in the area of Vedic mathematics and the other in multivariate hypergeometric function, a very advanced area in the mathematics. Figures will only speak of his prodigious output and efforts. So far in his active career, he has to his credit 132 published articles on mathematics and its history, 28 articles on non-mathematical topics, 125 papers and invited talks, editorship of 27 works, 21 articles in commemorative volumes, etc. Of late, he is fully engrossed as chief editor of 2 very prestigious research magazines, Arhat Vachan from Indore and Gyanadeshana from Meerut. His editorship of these magazines has unearthed a number of ancient works of Jaina mathematicians which were not known earlier. For example, Sridhar, Hemaraj, Thakkar Feru, etc., and 9 unpublished manuscripts on mathematics by Jaina writers were brought to light. He is connected with 30 institutions in the capacity of member or advisor or secretary or president on editorial boards of prestigious magazine. He was on editor board of prestigious international magazine Ganita Bharati, a bulletin of Indian Society of History of Mathematics, for several years. He is advisor to Florida International University, Miami, US. Needless to add that he is associate member of SOAS, this present organization which is arranging this conference. Since 1999, he had undertaken a big activity of unearthing ancient manuscripts authored by Jaina scholars, written in the very script which is very hard to decipher. And they were lying unnoticed in various bhandaras. Bhandara means in various Jain temples, there are stores of scriptures, old books written in handwriting, etc. He is involved in that activity. Spread all over India, it was very difficult to decipher the script of these works, but with dogged determination and persistence, thousands of such scriptures could be catalogued and studied. This will be a great source of research in future. The subject matter of his talk today is related to this activity only. He has so far organized 9 international conferences on Jain mathematics, science, and philosophy. For his marathon efforts and services of Jainism, he showered with many awards, to be exact, 32 awards, including conferring on him the title of Ganitacharya, means Master of Mathematics, at the hands of Honorary Governor of Uttar Pradesh. On the home front, he is blessed with his better half, Nishaji, who is present today, who has ably assisting him in his domestic and academic activities, and 3 sons pursuing very successful professional careers. I think we are going to greatly benefit by his talk today. Thank you, sir.
Honorable Professor Wright, Dr. Peter Flugel, senior scholars like Dr. Hampa Nagarajaya, so many faculty members of SOAS and research scholars, and the professors came from India, and friends. The topic of my today's lecture is newly discovered Jain mathematical manuscripts and their content. It is connected with three things: Jainism, mathematics, and manuscript. Jainism, there is no need to introduce Jainism because the conference organized by the Jain Center. Mathematics, I am a man of mathematics, and in ancient India, a branch of knowledge comes in the category of physical sciences. In ancient India, it was a part of astronomy, but nowadays it is very vast and varied, having several branches itself. And manuscript, a handwritten document, at least 75 years old, that has significant scientific, historical, or aesthetic values. It may be written on any material: stone, paper, cloth, wood, leather, brick bark, or palm leaf. So my topic is related with the three things. I will try to make the justice with all the three things. Because it is related with the mathematics and Jainism both, so there is a class of the studies which is known as Jain School of Mathematics. So mathematics, question arises, what is Jain mathematics? Mathematics found in Jain canonical literature or in the literature written by Jainacharyas or Jain scholars is known as Jain School of Mathematics or simply Jain mathematics. It is a part of the Indian mathematics, hence we can call it Jaina School of Indian Mathematics. It is included in major class History of Mathematics. So some people ask me a question, what is Jain mathematics? It is arithmetic, algebra, geometry. We know the branch of the mathematics, analysis, pure mathematics, applied mathematics, which is Jain mathematics. So this is clarification that it is not a branch of the mathematics. Of course, according to American Mathematical Society classification, it comes under the major class History of Mathematics. When it came into picture, before 1929, no one knows the word Jain School of Mathematics. The first paper on Jain School of Mathematics was written by Professor B.B. Dutt in Calcutta, in Bulletin of Calcutta Mathematical Society, and first time he used the word Jain School of Mathematics. But Jain School of Mathematics came into picture without the name in 1908 when Professor David Eugen Smith, a well-known historian of mathematics, produced a paper, Ganit Sar Sangraha of Mahavira Acharya, and a lecture was given in Rome and it is published in Bibliotheca Mathematica. Ganit Sar Sangraha, which is very popular and known text of Jain School of Mathematics, published by Madras government in 1912 with English translation of M. Rangacharya, and its Hindi translation by L.C. Jain appeared in 1963. Nowadays, the Kannada and Telugu translation are also available. So in this way, Jain School started to function in 1912, but the term coined in 1929. Now, why it should be studies? People say, why you are giving such emphasis on the studies of mathematics? Acharya Shri Mahapragya says that without the knowledge of the mathematics, no one can do justice with the Jain philosophical mathematics. And the reason is, according to Digambar classification, subject-wise classification, the entire Jain literature can be classified in four parts: Prathamani Yoga, Karnani Yoga, Charnani Yoga, and Dravyani Yoga. According to Shvetambar tradition, which is almost the same, the classification is Dharma Kathani Yoga, Charan Karnani Yoga, Ganitani Yoga, and Dravyani Yoga. So sections which are underlined means Karnani Yoga and Dravyani Yoga, and according to Shvetambar tradition, Karnani Yoga and the Gartani Yoga are full of mathematics. Regarding 72 arts, 72 arts, a reference of Ganit is found in Bhagavati Sutra, Lehiyao Ganiya Pahanao, means script, etc., but full of mathematics. That indicates the importance of mathematics in Jain canonical literature. Mahaviracharya's Ganit Sarasangra is a very popular text, and in that very text, in first chapter, he writes, Bahu bhirvi pralapaikim trailokke sacharachare yat kinchidastu tena tam ganitena nahi. Means, what is good of saying much in vain, whatever there is in all the three words which are possessed of moving and non-moving things, all that in it cannot exist as apart from mathematics. Now, what is the purpose of developing mathematics in Jainism? The question arises, why the persons giving so much importance and the ancient Jain acharyas giving so much importance in importance to mathematics, and what is their purpose? The purpose is, broadly we can write some points, that is, to explain cosmological details and the description of the threefold universe. It is used in giving the length, area, and volume of the different section of this threefold universe. Because the cosmological studies cannot be made without the knowledge of the mathematics. So the for cosmology, cosmography, and the cosmogony, the knowledge of the mathematics is essential. The text like Suri Pragyapti, Chandra Pragyapti, Jambudi Pragyapti, Tiloe Parnati, Dhavala, Triloksar, Jambudi, Parnati, Sangho, etc. cannot be studied without the knowledge of the mathematics. Therefore, first purpose is to explain the cosmological details. The second is to explain different types and subtypes of the karmas, their operation of the uprising, binding, shedding of the karmas, and the net effect of their infinitude of combinations. Because there are two major fields, one the cosmological studies, another is the karmic studies. And regarding the karmic studies, the text Kashaya Pahul, Churna Sutra, Gomatsar, Jeevakand, Karmakand, and the canonical text like Bhagavati Sutra, Sthanang Sutra are full of karmic theory. Dr. Shah is present here, who is introducing me. Is working on the Panch Sangraha and some other karmic text. So the studies of the karmic theory is another field in which mathematics used. Therefore, Jain Acharya giving much emphasis for the mathematics. And third one is to get the auspicious place and time for the religious ceremonies like Diksha and Pratistha. It is very much important. Without Muhurt, no Diksha performed in Jain tradition. So this is third reason. And the fourth is to train the people in basic mathematics, Laukik Ganit, required in daily life. Therefore, we find so many texts of Pati Ganit written by the Jain Acharyas just for the sake of the common person, because Jain Acharyas not only write the philosophical text, they write the text related with the mathematics, astronomy, grammar, and architect, etc. also, which are useful for the common man. And unfortunately, this part was ignored. If we put forward all these texts, then we find that Jain Acharyas are how much interested for the upliftment of the mankind and the society too. And to explain the Jain logic system, which is used for establishment of the logical facts and reconcilement of the others' views, modern mathematical logic is available in the text of the Jain Nyaya. As you know, Pramey Kamal Martand, Ashta Sahasri, Nyayasar are the very famous texts of the Jain logic. And the Jain Nyaya text cannot be studied without the appropriate knowledge. In modern mathematics, we teach the students 4 or 5 operations in the Jain logic, and they are all similar to the operations which is used in the Jain logic too. Now, when these 5 are the purposes, then how many texts was published so far? As I have mentioned earlier, that the canonical text, all the Angas, Upang, we are full of mathematics. Bhagavati Sutra, Sthananga Sutra, Anayogdwar Sutra, Uttaradhyan Sutra, Jambudi Pragyapti, Suri Pragyapti, Chandra Pragyapti, and Shatkhandagam, Dhavala,
Tilopanati, Tralokasar, Gomatsar, Jivkan, Karamkan are full of mathematics. But I am concentrating here non-canonical class. Non-canonical class, in this very class, which purely of mathematics, purely related with the mathematics, they have nothing to do with the philosophical details. And in this category, we find Trishatika of Sridharacharya. It is published in 1899 as a non-Jain text, and its new edition with the Sumedha translation appeared in 2004. The Ganesar Sangraha of Mahaviracharya, first published, as I told you, in 1912. Hindi translation from Solapur, 1963, and Kannada translation from Homebush, 2000, and Telugu translation from Hyderabad in 2003. Ganitilak commentary on the Pati Ganita of Sripati, written by Sim Talapsuri, is published by Gaikwad Oriental Series in 1937. Behar Ganit, published by Madras government in 1955, and the new translation with Kannada translation and the English translation appeared in 2012, and this translation was made by Professor Padmavathamma, our senior colleague. A Ganesh Sarakomdi of Thakkar Feru, first published from Baroda in 1961, and recently Professor S.R. Sharma, he was initially in Aligarh Muslim University, and at present he is in Germany, with his team published a new edition of Ganesh Sarakomdi of Thakkar Feru, and that appeared from Manohar Books in 2009. And Stang Panchavinshatika of Tej Singh Suri appeared in 2006 with its English translation by Takao Hayashi, our friend. And of course, in mathematics, it is very difficult to translate the things, because for translating any Jain mathematical text, knowledge of the Jain philosophy, knowledge of the Prakrit or Sanskrit, or the language in which it is initially written, or the Kannada, which is a Kannadese, if it is in Kannadese script, then the knowledge of the Kannadese script is essential, and the knowledge of the mathematics too. So this is a very rare combination. Some people are expert in mathematics. They do not know the Kannada, they do not know the Prakrit, and if they do not, they know the Prakrit, then they are not well-versed with the Jain philosophical term, because so many philosophical terms come in the text that without knowledge of the subject matter, any mathematics, language, and the Jain philosophy, it is not possible to translate the thing. Therefore, in some cases, we get only original text. And Angul Saptati, Lilavati of Lal Chanda, Anka Prastar, and Jyotir Gyan Vidhi, these four texts, only original published so far, there is no translation is available. And as my topic is newly discovered Jain mathematical text, I am listing here 18 such mathematical texts which are unnoticed, unpublished, and I just want to introduce here first time this list here, so that the people who are capable to translate the Jain mathematical text come forward and re-earth all these things and translate it and prepare the critical edition, so that the humanity will benefit with the knowledge contained in this very. The Ganesh Saso Mahimodaya, written by Mahimodaya, and the manuscript is available in Abhay Granthagar of Bikaner. Ganesh Sar of Anand Kavi, this is also unpublished, unknown, in the History of Mathematics by David Eugene Smith, in the History of Mathematics by History of Hindu Mathematics by B.B. Dutt, or any text of History of Mathematics, either published from Open University America or from any country, doesn't mention the name of these texts. Ganesh Sar of Anand Kavi, the manuscript is available in the Sethia Library, Bikaner. Gani Vidya Parnati, Oriental Manuscript Lab, Royal Asiatic Society of Bengal. And Ganesh Sar, Ganit Sangra by Yellacharya, it is available in Bandarkal Oriental Research Institute of Pune. Kshetra Ganit of Nemi Chandra, it's only one copy available in Tholiya Upashray Grah of Ahmedabad. Kshetra Ganit of Som Tilak Suri, Its copy is available in Rajasthan Oriental Research Institute Library, Jodhpur, and Kshetra Samas Prakaran, Sri Chandrasuri. Its copy is mentioned in the Shantinath, in the catalog of Shantinath Jain Bhandar, Kambe, 135 number, Vrat Kshetra Samas, Vratti Siddhasuri, and Lagu Kshetra Samas Vratti, Jaisalmer Bhandar, Kshetra Samas Ratnashekhar Suri, Rori 2536. Rori means Rajasthan Oriental Research Institute Library. And Kshetra Samas by Simintalak Suri, Uttar Chhattisitika by Sridhar in Karanja, Ganesh Shastra of Rajaditya, Madras, Ganesh Shastra Gunabhadra in Karanja, Ganita Vilas by Chandram in the Jain Math of Moodbadri. And it is Professor Hampana, I request to Professor Hampana, it is very difficult because they are in Kannada script. If we are unable to even note the name of the manuscript because we do not know the Kannada script. So it is very much essential that a person who is well versed in the old Kannada script come forward, and there are so many manuscripts are available in the bhandars of Moodbadri. And especially in Moodbadri or in other bhandars of Karnataka, and the manuscript found in the bhandars of Karnataka are very reliable, very old, because they are all on palm leaf. And sometime they are 800 or more than, the subscribing period is more than 800. So, but in North India, we find the manuscript 200, 300, 400 years old only, but in the South India, we find the more old copies. Ganesh Sangraha Rajaditya, that is also available in Moodbadri. Ganit Vilas of Rajaditya, it is also available in Moodbadri. And Pudgal Bhangavritti by Nyay Vijay Ganiji, and this copy is available in Bhandarkar Oriental Research Institute, Pune. So these 18 manuscripts are available. Some of them I have seen personally, but I have not got the copy of these manuscripts. Now, I am giving you, as mentioned by Ratna Kumar Shah, that he collected 9 mathematical manuscripts. So, I have the copies of certain mathematical manuscripts which are not published. So, I am giving the details of one by one. This is Stang Panchavinshatika, the only one copy of Stang Panchvanshatika is available in the library of LD Institute, means Lal Bhai Dalpat Bhai Institute of Indology, Ahmedabad. And this is a manuscript of 3 folios only. Some details are given, and it is written by Lunka Gakshi Tej Singh Suriji, and he died in 1686, therefore it is sure that it is written before 1686. And subscribing period is 1813. The manuscript details are given here. Now, I have published its facsimiles in Aratvachan in 1988-89. Whenever I was doing PhD, I have got this copy of Stang Panchvanshatika. I am very much excited because nowhere the name is mentioned. Therefore, and it is not possible for me because it is very typical. I have published facsimiles only with the introduction of Tej Singh Suri. So about the life, his case, the name of the guru, etc. It is a work of 25 verses on arbitrary disease. Each verse prescribes a series of calculation or an algorithm that returns any number, a positive integer with a certain constant number, say p, that is significant for Jainism. For example, in the first stanza, a constant is 72, and he narrated that 72 is the length of life of Bhagwan Mahavir. Similarly, he given the some life span or the time spent for the establishment of the Lunka Gaksh. So many such type of things which are important from the history of Jainism are involved in 25 verses. Life span of the Bhagwan Parshnath. And a lot of controversy. Professor Sagar Malji is not here, but in spite of his absence, I am mentioning that he raised so many questions about the period of the Lord Mahavir. But Almost all the people say that 527 BC is the Nirvana period of the Lord Mahavir. But in so many books published from Parshanath Vidyashram Shodh Sansthan, he raised some question. Now, in this manuscript, the period of the Nirvana is mentioned 527 BC. So this small text is important in this way that he incorporated the mathematical skill to decipher or to give the different events of history of Jainism. And it is also important from this very point of view that with the help of this, we can resolve so many controversies too. It is composed in Sardul Vikridit and Vasant Tilaka meter. Last one is in Upjati. Many historical events are mentioned in this text, like Veer Nirvana. It is important to resolve the controversy regarding it. Now, the second is the Ganesar by Sridhara. And this is the first page of this very text. The name is Trishatika, which is popular, but the name which is mentioned in this very text is Ganesar. And the details of this very manuscript given here, the number of the manuscript, whenever I visited the Jain Math Moodbadri, I have found and I have taken the photo of certain pages, and Pooja Swamiji, Panditacharya Swamiji, previous one, now the Bhattarak Charukirtiji, not which is present, but previous Bhattarak Charukirtiji, who is named as the Panditacharya, kindly provided us the photo of all the palm leaf manuscript, all the palm leaves of this very manuscript. And the so many copy of the Trishatika are available across the India, and not only India, in London too. Therefore, I am mentioning here in British Museum catalog number 5206 and under the name Patya Ganesar, India Office, London 6317, and Sindhya Oriental Research Institute, Ujjain, under the name Trishati, and in the Karanja Temple under the name 2110. Several manuscripts of the Trishatika collected from various places laying in the Department of Mathematics, University of Lucknow. Professor A.N. Singh, previously the head of the department in the Lucknow University, and he is very much interested in Jain School of Mathematics. Professor Hiralal Jain inspired him to study mathematics of Dhawla, and he write a very important paper, Mathematics of Dhawla, that is published with the Dhawla Book 4. And Jaina Sources for History of Mathematics is a very excellent paper, which is published in the Warning Commemorative Volume also. Therefore, he is very much interested, and he collected the several copies of the Trishatika, and they are all preserved. Not original copy, because no one will provide the original copy. So he take the photos. At that time, there was no so much facility of the photocopying. In 50s, I think photocopy method was not very popular. So he collected photo by camera, and sometimes he copied by hand, and they are preserved in the Department of Mathematics, University of Lucknow. But the published version of Trishatika, one published by published from Banaras in 1899, and it is edited by Sudhakar Dwivedi. And this will contain only 172 shlokas only. And the Trishatika, which is recently published in 2004, with the translation, Sumedha translation of Sudhyumna Acharya, and published by Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan, this contain only the same 172 shlokas. The published version contained 65 formulas and 107 examples. So 172. These figures doesn't match with the word Trishatika. As those person who know Sanskrit, Trishatika means 300. I have got a copy of the Ganesar from Moodbadri, and some copies are transcript of its Lucknow, from Lucknow University. On the basis of it, one enlarged edition has been prepared, which contained 305 plus 12. It is closer to word Trishatika. There, This is not exactly 300, but it is more closer to Trishatika. I think there will be some chepak which can be removed on the basis of the linguistic, and then a more, the enlarged edition have two important shlokas and they are missing here. So I am remembering, Natva janam savirchit patya ganitasya sara mudratya lok vyavaharaya pravakshatri Sri Dharacharya. So this is the shloka, this is the Mangalacharan, which is mentioned by Acharya Sridhara. And the second one is also the translation Sridharacharya bowing to Lord Jin tells the substance of mathematics as extracted from the party composed by himself for the use of the people. And the second sloka is Vrashave Sambhave Pancha Saptondurta Dishae Vimale Ardham Chaturdwaram Kramanaikam Chadashate. So in this sloka, Vrishava Sambhava, we know that the name of the first Tirthankar is Vrishabhanath, third is the Sambhavanath, and the Vimalnath. These are the names of the Tirthankar, and the translation which is provided by the Suddhimna Acharya, our other person is not, no. The translation which is made by Usha Asthana in the PhD thesis submitted in the Lucknow University is not proper. He translated Vimal as the cleaning, as a cleaning. So this type of misinterpretation was made due to the fact the person is not aware with the Jain tradition or the Jain philosophy. That's why I have mentioned that the knowledge of the Jain philosophy is very much essential for the translation of the Jain mathematical text. The person who is not acquainted with the fact that the Vrishabh is the name of the first Tirthankara, Sambhavanath is the name of the third Tirthankara, how he will translate? And that's why he committed so many mistakes. And the another text of the same Sridhar is, I have got the three copies. One is available in Mudbadri, but I can't read it. Therefore, I am not given here. But the copy is available. I confirm with the Swami, Charukirtiji Swamiji, that the copy is available in the Mudbadri. And I have got the transcript of that very copy, which is available in the Ara. And that is the first copy, which is Jain Siddhanta Bhavan Ara. And the second is the copy which is found in the Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Ujjain. The three bhandars, Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Mumbai, Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Ujjain, and Elak Pannalal Saraswati Bhandar Biyawar, Rajasthan. These three bhandars are very rich. And those people who are interested in the Jain manuscript must visit these three bhandars. Because I think that I have not seen, because he is very senior. Elak Pannalalji collected several manuscripts, copied them, and put them in the bhandars. Therefore, these bhandars are very helpful for the study of the ancient text. Like Shravan Velugula, Mudbadri bhandars. In Mudbadri bhandar, we have got the Dhavla. In Mudbadri bhandar, we have got the several copies of the text of the Acharya Kundukund. So, Jyotir Gyan Vidhi, and the details of the Jyotir Gyan Vidhi is given here. It is a text of astronomy. With the help, and important thing, Jyotir Gyan Vidhi is a very important text of the astronomy. The muhurt, the rules regarding finding the muhurt of Pratishtha is as it is quoted by Vasunandi Acharya in the Pratishtha part. But the original text, Jyotir Gyan Vidhi, is still unpublished. I have got the copy, two copies, and with the help of you have prepared a list of the content. There are 10 chapters, Sangyadhikar, Dhruvadhikar, Tithyadhikar, Sankranti, Ratthohoratri, Pramanadhikar, Graha Nilayadhikar, Graha Yuddhadhikar, Grahanadhikar, Lagna Prakran, Ganita, Ganitadhikar, and Muhurtadhikar. And this is very authentic. the people of the astronomy informed that the process of finding the muhurt and the lagna are still in use. And Tithyadhikar, in that Tithyadhikar, the rule of the Jain astronomy of Udayatithi are mentioned. There is a difference in the astronomical details of Jain and Hindu text. In Hindu text, the decision of the tithi is made on the basis of how long it is in that very day. But in Jain tradition, in the morning, if the two ghadi is that very tithi, then it is accepted. So this is the difference which is mentioned in the Bharati Jyotish by Dr. Naimi Chand Shastri Jyotishacharya. So the text is very important, and it should be published by any person who is well-versed in the Jain astronomy or Ganit Jyotish. Now, Shatrinshika. Shatrinshatika of Madhav Chandra Trivedi. As I have mentioned that Ganesh Sar Sangra is very important text and very popular too, because it is translation in Hindi, in English, in Kannada, in Telugu, and across the India, we find several copies of it. But a great mistake committed by the different persons who is engaged in this very work. The Shatrinshatika is a work of Madhav Chandra Trivedi, but everywhere it is mentioned as an incomplete copy of the Ganesh Sar Sangra. Here, on page number 35, which is shown here, it is mentioned, Shri Vitragaya Namah, 36 me sakal aat bhinna jati che, prakirnak das trairashik char, inta 36 budhviracharya ru, pillaganatvanu, Madhav Chandra Trivedya. I have underlined this, Madhav Chandra Trivedya, charya ru, sodh siddharadis, sodh sangrahamenis kum budhu. Budhu Shriman, Pellaganit Pehle Kahege. These two words are from the Kannada background. Therefore, the northern Indian people cannot explain this very thing. When I visited Shravan Belgola, Pooj Bhattarak Swamiji, and Pandit Bahubali Upadhyay in 1981, assisted me, and he said that Pellaganit Mani Pehle Kahege, yani previously known, previously declared. And Budhu means Shriman, Aap. It is a word of honor only. So whenever I have gone through the content of this very text, these are the details of manuscript and other manuscript. There are so many manuscripts I have found. And whenever I have examined that, if any manuscript by S.N. Sen mentioned as an incomplete manuscript by Professor L.C. Jain, Professor Hiralal Jain, Professor A.N. Upadhyay mentioned these are the incomplete manuscript of Ganesh Sar Sangraha. I have found that, of course, they have the first four chapter, but these are the Ganesh Sar Sangraha. First four chapter are same in Shatrinshatika. And he mentioned also that Sodh Siddharagi of Sar Sangraha. It means on the basis of the Ganesh Sar Sangraha of Mahaviracharya, Madhav Chandra say that I have prepared this very short Shatrinshatika. So this is the verse portion, Shri Vitragaya Namah. This is the same thing. And the chapter of GSS, which is found in the Shatrinshatika, are following Sangyadhikar, Parikaram Vyavahar, Kala Savarna Vyavahar, Prakirnaka Vyavahar, and Trairashik Vyavahar. These four chapters are in the published version. Sangyadhikar and Parikram Vyavahar are separated. So we find that these five chapters are the same. But in Shatrinshatika, we find these 13 additional formulae. Varga Sankalitanen Sutram, Gana Sankalitanen Sutram, Ek Dwaradi Sankalit Ghananayan Sutram, Sarv Ghananayan Sutra Dvayam, Uttarottarchay Bhava. So these 13 formulae, in the first four chapter, we find the operation of eight fundamental operations on fractions. Then Bhinnajati means six type of fractions, and Prakirnak, operations and the applied questions related with the fractions and Trayarashik is well known to all of you, that regarding proportion, etc., Ichhakar questions, they are Trayarashik. So the 36 type of things which is discussed in the first 5 chapters of the Ganesar Sangraha are taken as it is. But there are certain things which is essential, and they are related with the series. They are related with the geometry, and they are related with the 2 typical problems which is discussed by the Acharya Sridhara. If 2 person start from a same point with the 2 velocities, or after a period of half an hour, person start with the different velocity, when they will meet, this type of question is discussed in Pati Ganit by Sridharacharya. But in the first 4 or 5 chapters up to Trayarashik, there is no details of such type of questions. So these type of question, how solve? So the formula for that very is given here. And Sanyoganayana Sutram. Sanyoganayana Sutram. Under this heading, the process of solving this type of situation is given. And if person borrow certain money from any vanik, any landlord, then what will be the interest? And in how many days, even that EMI is a very popular word at present word, equally monthly installment. So what will be the equal monthly installment? This type of question is discussed here in Vanikkara Sthiti Gharanayana Sutram. So this type of with the problems, any typical problems, series and geometry are discussed, and under these 13 chapters are the formula with illustration, all the things discussed. Apart from it, Madhav Chandra Trivedya illustrated certain formulae which is given in the Ganesar Sangraha with the help of certain examples added by him. And in the last, he has given the magic square of 34. In the Jain temples, we find the many yantras, they bear the different magic squares, 35, 25, 34, 25, 15, 64, etc. So what is the use and why they are given so much importance, I do not know, and I do not want to comment on it. But here it is important that they have mentioned the magic square of 34. Now, Lokani Yog, this is Jinsen, as I have told you, the Jains given much importance to cosmological studies, and entire Ganitani Yog is full of cosmological things. The details of this manuscript, and this manuscript is available in Kumbhoj Bahubali of Kolhapur, as well as in the Karanja Lad, and this written by the Acharya Jinsen. In Trailoki Deepaka Pandit Bamdev, we find a copy of it in Delhi, written in 1386. 1386. So this text is written before that. 1379. And so many copies are available in Khajuraho, in Chanderi, in Ujjain, and Trilok Darpan of Pandit Khadaksen. Khadaksen, nothing is new in this very script, but importance is this: it is first text of mathematics, cosmological mathematics, cosmological details, which is written in Devanagari script and in Hindi. In Hindi, as you know, Om Namah Siddhepya Shri Guru Bhya Namah Athi Trilok Darpan, Hindi Bhasha Likhyate. Om Namah Siddhan Munijan Rai. So this is in Hindi, this is its importance. So it is written in 1656. Several other manuscripts are available in Sonagir, Gwalior, Sivni Malwa, Indore, Sanawat, Bina, Sivni, Shivpuri, Khargapur, etc. And it is the oldest book on Jain cosmology written in Hindi. Of course, cosmological books are so many old, but in Hindi it is first book. And this is the Ganesar of Thamraj of 17th century. This is the first text on number theory. Written in Hindi. And as Sri Pati Sundara Sugata Vidhi Nirvikar Kartar Agam Sugam Anandamay Sur Narapati Suro Narapati Sartar. So in this way, it is the importance of this is it is written in Hindi, and we find in this that the type of number, countable, uncountable, and finite is mentioned in this very text, nothing else. In 89 shlokas, in 89 pad, it is mentioned, and Guru Prasad Avadhar Lokottara Giniti Karu, Trivida Tasu Parivar, Sankhya Sankhya Anantakari, Trivida Bheda Sankhyata Vichar, Asankhyata Nau Parakar, Nahi Vidijin Keho Anand, Avus Inko Sun Lo Virtant. This classification is available in Sthanang, in Bhagavati, in Anayogdwar, in Jammudi Pragyapti, in Tiloy Parnati, in Trilok Sar, in Jammudi Parnati Sango. Everywhere the same type of ka details is available. Somewhere we find minute details, difference in the Anantanant. In the Anantanant are the quantities which is added. We will find some difference. But in entire tradition, in Digambar and Shatambar both, this classification is almost 99% same. But the beauty of this is in Hindi. And he writes, Sankhya Sankhya Anantake Ei Bhedikis Thul Rupa Kinchit Kahe Suksham Jane Is. So in this way, he has illustrated thing in very simple manner. Yes. And I have collected this very manuscript, which is shown here, from a small town, Ganj Basoda Vidisha. And other known manuscripts are from Jaipur, Bundi, and a copy of the Bundi is available in Kundukund Gyanpit in Indore library. Ganesh Saraf Hemraj is probably first Indian completely mathematical text written in Hindi poetry. The text deals with the unique Jaina classification system of number. And there are some controversies about the Ganesh Sar Sangra. It is said that the mention that x upon 0 is equal to x is wrong. As a man of mathematics, I am also say that x upon 0 is not x. It should be infinity. Any number divided by 0 is infinity. But according to logical system, according to Nayayik point of view, if x thing is distributed among 0 person, what will be the change? If I have certain thing, these 100 books, and if we distribute in among the 0 person, means we not distribute, then the things will remain same. There will be no change. This is the idea. And this is ignored by M. Rangachari. And then they have copied only. The further translator copied or followed the view of the Rangachari. And this very Uttar Chhattisi Tika, which is recovered from the Byavar, the illustration is given that yx upon 0 is x, mentioned by the Mahaviracharya. So certain charges, which is one more charge, the rule for finding the area of a quadrilateral, which is mentioned by the Ganesha Mahaviracharya, is not correct. But the things when we see that the rule, when illustrated with the example, that it is Chakriya Chaturbhuja. So this is a typical problem. And if it is used for that very case, then the rule is correct. And if we use it for general case, then it will be not proper. So whenever we find the certain commentaries, the formula and the validity of formula can be checked in more better way. And the limitation of the formula can be explained and analyzed with the help of certain such type of commentaries. The name is Uttar Chhattisi Tika, but really it is the commentary of the Ganesar Sangra made by Bhattarak Sumati Kirtiji, and the so many copy of this is available, but this copy we have recovered from Biavar, and other copies available in Udaipur, etc. And recently, within 2-3 months, I have recovered Lagu Sangrahani Sutra from Hat Pipliya, a very small town of Devas district, and Sangrahani Sutra Balabodh by Ganesh Gyan Bhandar. It is from Gyan Gach of Sthanakvasi tradition, and this is a very old manuscript, about 600 years old, and it is recovered from Ratlam. Now, in this case, what is our responsibility? Our responsibility to get the copies of these manuscripts from the Bhandars and print the facsimiles or put them on the internet immediately so that the interested and the capable scholars may translate them and evaluate critically their content. Nowadays, people do not give easily the copy of the manuscript. And the Copyright Act creates so many problems. And National Mission for Manuscript, who collected the data of different Jain Bhandars, is bound not to put on the website because intellectual property right came in between. Therefore, I have contacted him. Ali Sandra is not here. She asked a question that is there is any commentary before Singh Tilak Suri is available in Jain tradition? I have analyzed 8,000 datas available with National Mission for Manuscript. Being a coordinator for Madhya Pradesh, I have a facility to enter in these datas. And I have found that no commentary before Singh Tilak Suri is written on any completely mathematical text. If she will come, she is doing work on Ganit Tilak of Singh Tilak Suri. Tomorrow she may come. So then I will inform him. She mailed me and I have said that I will try to get the answer of your question. I have found that no commentary before Singh Tilak Suri is available according to my knowledge. There may be some. So if any commentary procured or found, then it will be an achievement. But this is the research. And if we find, then we change our idea. And naturally, this is my responsibility to acknowledge the assistance provided in collecting so many data, especially Jain Vishwabharati, Sansthan Ladnu, Gyan Sagar Science Foundation, National Mission for Manuscript, Government of India, and Kundukund Gyanpeet. All are very helpful, and with the help of these, we have collected these data, which will establish a foundation for the further studies in the field of Jain School of Mathematics. The text which is recovered so far are the canonical text. A lot of work has been done. Even then, so many texts of non-canonical castes are ignored, and they have a lot of information which is useful for us, and it is our responsibility to preserve them for the new generation, for further generation. I'm also thankful to SOAS, Center for Jain Studies, for providing me an opportunity to come here and to interact all of you, so great scholars who is working in this very field. Thank you. Jai Jainendra.